Today, we are back on another Adobe Premiere tutorial, and we are focusing on workflow, editing faster and easier with short keys and my brand new toy, Loupedeck CT right here. We'll talk about why you will invest in a controller for video editing, and then I will show you how I program my Loupedeck CT to fit my unique editing style, which is 360 VR videos and massively long YouTube tutorial about 360 VR filmmaking. If you are looking for investing in a Loupedeck CT as a videographer, this will be a great review and tutorial for you. If you just want to learn some of my Premiere workflow tips and tricks for 360 VR editing and program it with short keys and your old school keyboards, this will also be a great tutorial as well. We have a lot to cover, so let's go. Loupedeck CT, worth it? So, some background story why I end up getting the Loupedeck CT. If you are a long time follower of Creator Up, you know recently I am upping my YouTube game by releasing epic tutorials and reviews every single week. Some of them are 35 minutes long. This is on top of my full-time job as a 360 VR director and post supervisor. Spending almost 12 hours a day in front of a computer made me really rethink how I can improve my workflow. I did try before this little thing, this controller right here, and I end up throwing it in the trash can. Mainly because it's really hard to program and it is not responsive. Then I found Loupedeck CT, which built on the same concept as a DJ controller, like the Ableton Launchpad I have right here. In fact, the build quality of Loupedeck CT is so high, it can be used live with Ableton for DJing. Why does your boy know anything about DJing? Well...
Zhao Yu, press play.
Let me be honest with you, this thing is not gonna replace your keyboard, at least for video editing with Premiere. If you have 10 plus years of experience in Adobe Premiere editing like your boy right here, and expect this will improve your editing speed immediately, well, it's not gonna happen. In fact, if you slow you down at the beginning until you rebuild some muscle memory with the controller, think about it as an instrument. Like a piano, it takes time to learn and master. But when you do, you play beautiful music. If you don't make a living with editing, I don't know you should spend and invest $500 on a controller. The money will be better spent on a better graphic card or a faster SSD drive. If you have those already and you are a professional video editor or content creator, I will suggest combining your Loupedeck CT with your keyboard and mouse and slowly program it to your liking. With patience, after a month or so, you will have your own template that you feel very comfortable to play on, and your editing will become fun and fast. And that is exactly what I'm going to show you in this tutorial. My way of thinking and how I make Loupedeck CT to fit my editing style. If you don't have the Loupedeck CT, you can just replace it with keyboard shortcut, so you can still follow along. Program Loupedeck CT for 360 VR editing. The best way to learn how to edit faster with a controller is to use it. If you are a musician or DJ, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So let's open up Premiere and check out my template and short keys on 360 VR video editing. By the way, I will provide my template to download in the description down below, free with love. Don't forget to share this on your social media and give me a like. As you see right here, I align my Loupedeck CT against my left side of my keyboard. I will go so far that I will use a 3M dual lock to lock the Loupedeck and the keyboard together on the table, so they stay in the exact same location every time I edit. so I can develop muscle memory. This is the trick I learned in my DJ career. If I have multiple controllers on deck, I need to get to them without looking, so I can focus on the music and the audience and using touch and muscle memory to control everything. You should do the same thing for video editing. My Loupedeck will look a lot different than yours because I customize it. Let's focus on 360 VR related controllers in this section and 2D video editing in the next section. Again, you can replace them with keyboard shortcut if you don't have the Loupedeck. I do audio edit a lot based on music. That is why my production goes so well with music. To do that, I change the audio height, use this knob a lot so I can see the waveform, find my edit point, and reduce the height again when I'm done. To program a knob to do that, it is very easy while Premiere is running. Tap the Loupedeck logo right here to bring up Loupedeck configuration. Click the knob you want to program, let's say video height. Go to search, type in audio, and if you show all the audio related action, you can program on the knob. Just drag and drop on the knob and you are ready to go. There is a display on the controller to tell you what that is right here. So if you forgot what the knob does, it will tell you. Close that and go back into Premiere. I use select clip and zoom into timeline a lot, so that's why you see them right here. In VR, there is a button you click a lot. It's the toggle VR display button to turn your preview window into an immersive viewer, like so. I can program a button or a short key to do that quickly, but I found that it's not necessary in a real production situation. It is as easy to use your mouse to click it as tapping a button, so we are not wasting a button on it. This is the kind of logical thinking you need to do to design what goes on the Loupedeck or your keyboard and what is not. As you see on my Loupedeck, there are two VR related buttons there. They are crucial for VR editors. This is a stereoscopic video shot on the Insta 360 Titan. Right now, you only see monoscopic. How do we know if the stereoscopic is correct and there is no vertical disparity? We need to quickly switch between anaglyph and left and right eyes. Without short key, here is how you do it. You right click on the video, scroll down to VR video, go to settings, and open up VR video settings. In here, you choose your stereoscopic view dropdown to pick the settings and then hit OK. That is a 6-step process. With Loupedeck, you tap here to bring up the VR video settings immediately, choose your eyes, and then tap confirmed button on the Loupedeck. It is a 3-step process with minimal mouse movement, and you can quickly switch between view, and it's very fast. Again, Adobe should really make it into a one-button operation. This feature request has been sitting in the queue for more than 1 year now, and still not there. So, it is the next best alternative. Another essential feature is to increase your VR viewing windows by getting rid of the VR video controls. As you see right here, these take up lots of space, but we also need them to fine-tune the degrees of panning in VR rotate sphere for horizontal leveling, stabilization, transition, object removal, and literally everything. So the way to switch back and forth without short key is right-click, go to VR video, and uncheck show controls. I can tell you before Loupedeck, I just live with the smaller screen and never change that. It's a 4-step process. No way I'm wasting my time on that. With Loupedeck, it's a tap of a touch screen. Look at that, so convenient. Okay, let me show you how to program the touch screen. Tap the Loupedeck logo again. In search bar, type VR. You see all the VR control you can program. It has a lot. Some of them are even for VR headset editing. I will let you explore the best way to use all this. The program just drag and drop the action onto any touchscreen button, and that's it. If you close a Loupedeck configuration, you see the display change right here as well. No need to restart Loupedeck or Premiere to take effects. Amazing. The scroll wheel is probably the best feature of Loupedeck. You can slow scroll to find the edit point, fast scroll to jump through clips, tap the center to play the video and tap it again to stop playback. You can swipe right to go to a different scroll wheel, and there you can have the fine control to scroll in one frame or five frame to find the perfect edit point. Swipe left to go back to the previous window. This playback control is ridiculous. I have clients just take control and they love it. Return business to justify the cost of the Loupedeck. As a visual effects and 360 VR or VR 180 editors, we use the effect controls and effects panel a lot. So we need a physical button just to smash and switch back and forth. The default Loupedeck circle button 4 and 5 above the scroll wheel is set to in and out point. I much prefer my old school keyboard way, which is I and O. As I said, if you have muscle memory on some of your keyboard shortcuts, you should keep it that way. Free up the button to do program into things that will speed up your process. To me, it is to bring up the effects panel and effects control panels. As you see the first clip right here, we need to level and reorient the footage. We select the clip, tap 4 to bring up effects panel, open up often used folder, and here is another workflow tips. Organize all your often used effects into a custom folder, so when you need them, you tap 4 and often used folder is already open up. You just pick the effects and drag and drop very fast. Now tap 5 to go to effect control panel, and you can start immediately to adjust your setting. To assign this to your Loupedeck, open up the Loupedeck configuration again, search for effects, and find those actions to drag and drop onto the circular button. If you hover your mouse on the circular button, it tells you what they are if you forgot. Program Loupedeck CT for ultra fast 2D editing. So I have a really unique editing style that ensures speed and accuracy for all my super long tutorial on YouTube. To do that, I want my right hand on my mouse and my left hand on my Loupedeck with minimal movement. The shorter distance your hand and your fingers need to move, the faster you can edit. In here, I have E button as add edit, so my thumb can tap it and cut. C and D as a one frame micro adjustment to find the edit point. My index finger will tap the B for a ripple delete, and A, just a regular delete to leave a space for inserting graphics. I also copy and paste effects a lot from clip to clip, so I have 7 as copy, just like the Ctrl C, but with just a button, and A as paste. You cannot paste effects with just a regular paste, so here is another big time saver for you. You can copy and paste all the effects, animation, audio edit, and lumetri color grading from clip to clip. So I set the function key plus A as paste attributes, so my hand does not need to go anywhere to do copy and paste attributes. If you don't have Loupedeck, make sure you make these short keys on your keyboard for paste attribute to save you a ton of time for copy and paste. Let me show you everything in action now. So I have my first clip colored and adjust VR leveling and even have audio level set. I hit the 7 to copy, my thumb hold Fn, and my index finger tap A on the next clip. I can select what I want to copy over on the next clip. For fast edit, I control my playhead with my pinky and the scroll wheel, find the edit point, tap E to cut, tap B to ripple delete, use my ring finger to tap the center of the scroll wheel to see the edit, and move on to the next cut point. The whole process without me to move my hand at all, just my fingers. This is my editing secret to push out 35-minute long tutorial every single week. I hope you do not copy it exactly, but if you do, please give this video a like and give me a shout out to thank me for saving you quality time. So if you tap 2, it will jump into color page when you can color grade with Lumetri color. It is very powerful, but I don't use Premiere to color, because Premiere sucks in coloring and generate banding and artifacts with Lumetri, especially for highly compressed 360 video. Any professional will tell you to use DaVinci Resolve, which is every Hollywood production house use, and it's free. So I will save the color grading part in the DaVinci Resolve coming up very soon. Loupedeck will work with DaVinci Resolve with macro and short keys. We will cover that in my coloring tutorial on DaVinci Resolve next. But I do want to cover audio editing and sound effects, which is very important for a great cinematic piece. The trailer you saw on this video, the video editing is very simple, but the sound design, as you see right here, is what makes it so powerful and cinematic. So if you tap 3, Loupedeck will have a dedicated audio editing page for exactly that. Let me quickly show you. Audio editing with Loupedeck CT. Right off the bat, you can control the audio level by selecting the audio clip and just turn your wheel. In here, we have a voiceover coming in. Let's add an audio fade by selecting the end or beginning of your transition point. Tap this button, boom, you add a constant power transition. It's that easy. Now, we need to dip the background music so we can hear the voiceover. So we need to add some keyframes. Click the pen looking icon on Loupedeck right here and click the timeline to insert keyframes. Now we can use the scroll wheel to select keyframe. Tap the center of the wheel to switch to the volume of the selected keyframe. Turn it to drop the volume. Tap again to switch back to selected keyframe. Select the next keyframe and drop the volume. If you change your mind of the keyframe location, you can use the audio KF horizontal knob to move the keyframe left and right here. Crazy convenient. So right now, the audio level is boring. We want to add easy ease or curve adjustment in the volume so the audio will drop more natural. Just like animation, you can hit the ease in curve or ease out curve directly on Loupedeck like so. Drag the handle and find the best ease amount. By the way, you can program the same thing on any animation in Premiere with Loupedeck. That is a lot more complicated course, so I will save that for my next animation essential tutorial on Adobe Premiere. If you use GoPro FX Reframe plugin to do reframe of your 360 video footage and do speed ram, this will be a great tutorial for you. I will teach you how to edit like GoPro with Loupedeck keyframe fine tuning. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. I hope you enjoyed this Premiere editing workflow tutorial. I demo it with Loupedeck, but all the buttons you see on Loupedeck CT is available in Adobe Premiere short key menu right here. You can program them accordingly on your keyboard or your gamer mouse as well. You just have to do it. Time is money. If you cannot afford Loupedeck, at least use short keys. If you like workflow tutorials like this and want me to review other control panels or more tutorials in Adobe Premiere or Adobe After Effects, please comment below and let me know what you want to learn next, and I will make them for you. If you are new to this channel, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell and stay up to date in 360 VR and 2D video editing tips and tricks. And I will see you next time. Ciao.